Welcome to Delta 12. My name is Michael, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create doors and keys.
A very simple way to create items that we can collect is to create a scene that has a sprite with the item's image and an area 2D that we will use to call the necessary functions. When the player takes the key, it will save its own name in a list of found keys. And later, when we created the doors, the code will search this list for the correct key. And so, we will see the animation of the door being opened or remaining closed. And finally, we are going to use color hacks that will change colors to represent these doors on the minimap.
Let's start by creating Node 2D and let's call it key. So in the world folder, let's look for the key and drag it to the scene. Let's leave this sprite's position at 0. Let's create an area 2D. And let's add a collision shape with a rectangular shape. Now in collision properties, let's mark layer 2 in mask, because this is the layer the player is on. And now we can add a script and connect a body entered signal. And for now, we will just use the carry-free command. Let's save the scene. Now we can instantiate this key on level 1 and let's run the game. Now I'm going to explain how the carry-free command works. The scene window opens a second tab called Remote, and this tab shows what is happening in the game in real time. By clicking on it, we can already see that the root node has already loaded the global and the level 1 scene. Now I want you to pay attention to the key node and see what happens. As you can see, as soon as the carry-free command is executed, the node is closed. Okay, now let's add a new variable in global to save the name of the keys that have already been found. So let's go back to the key and let's declare that. Before disappearing, our key node must be save its own name in the variable we just created. And then just for testing, let's use the print global key found. Okay, we will start with an empty string, go to the key. And now let's leave and go back to reload the scene. Okay, now as you can see, the variable saved the node name key. Now let's declare that when the scene is ready, if your own name is in the global key found and variable, we want the key to disappear using the curly free command. Okay, now we can delete the print command and let's create our doors. Let's create a new scene and add a static body 2D node. Let's call it door. And let's add a collision shape to block our player. Now let's create an area 2D and add a rectangular collision shape. And then, as for the size of this shape, it needs to be bigger than the previous zone, both top and bottom. Okay, don't forget to mark the collision mask. And then we can create a script and connect a signal. Now let's create the animations. Let's create the closed animation. Let's leave it with 0.5 seconds. And in the self-modulate properties, let's add a key. And then in 0.1, we are going to add a new key with the color red. Then we just need to duplicate these keys like that. And our effect is ready. Okay, now let's create the open animation. Let's leave it with 1.5 seconds. And we are going to do the same thing, but we are going to vary the alpha key. Okay, now we can save our scene DAW. And let's open the central scene. Let's add our first DAW. Let's duplicate it and add our second DAW. Okay, our DAWs are working, but the level 2 DAW is showing above the player. This is something very simple to solve. Let's rename the DAWs according to their levels. And let's leave DAW 2 above the player node and DAW 4 below. And okay, all right now. Let's go back to the level 1 and let's rename the key with the name of the DAW we want to open. In this case, DAW 2. Now let's open the DAW script and let's declare that when the player enters the DAW area, if the DAW name is in the key found variable, let's run the open animation, wait for it to finish and then carry free. And if the DAW name is not in the variable, let's run the closed animation. Okay, let's test. The two DAWs are closed. Let's get the key now. Let's try to open DAW 4. And now let's open DAW 2. Okay, let's enter level 2. And let's go back. Okay, as you could see, we need to make the DAW disappear now. For that, let's create another variable in global to save the name of the doors that have already been opened. And then let's declare that. When the animation ends, the door should add its own name to the variable. And then we just need to declare that. When the scene is ready, if the door name is inside the opened door variable, then carry free. Let's test. And okay, now everything is all right. Now we just need to open level 3 and add the door 4 key. And okay, everything is working perfectly. Okay, now one thing I think is important to explain is that, well, so far we've been using different scenes for keys and doors, right? But what if you want to leave the keys in the same scene as the doors? How would you do that? Okay, you can add the key normally, but let's see what happens when we try to rename it to door 2. As there is already a node named door 2 in the same hierarchy, and we can have two nodes with the same name, it is renamed door 3. So to solve this problem, we can create a new node and then make our door 4 a child node of this node we created. Doing this will all work in exactly the same way.